Hello and welcome into the 3D. Today we are going to create discount shield effect in Unreal Engine 5. First, you can download and import the texture that I provide in the descriptions. And basically, this is a simple hexagon texture coming with starter content of Unreal Engine. After that, right-click on this area and create a new material. We can rename this as shield material, and if you double-click on this, it will open the material graph. First, select the default shader, go under the details panel and change the blend mode to translucent and shading model to unlit. Also, if you want this effect to be visible from all sides, make sure to enable two-sided option. To begin with, we are going to create two constant 3 vector nodes. This is the first one, and you can also create it by holding 3 on your keyboard and left click on an empty area. Then make the first constant node any color that you like. I will go for blue. And the second one, I will make it all the way to the white. After that, create a linear interpolate node and connect the first color to the A, second color to the B, and let's move them a bit back. Now create a Fresnel node, and I will leave the default settings, but you can play around and see the effects of this. Then from the Fresnel node, create a cheap contrast and right-click on the contrast and promote it to a parameter. Then make the default value 0.2. If you just connect this to the alpha and the alert node to the emissive color, you will see the effect that we have created. Now create a depth fade, and from this one, let's create a 1 minus node and also we can create a max node. Okay, this one. Connect the 1 minus node to the B, chip contrast to the A, and the max node to the alpha of the alert node. Let's also change the fade distance default value to 20. And basically, this node will create a nice smooth effect when the edges of the material interact with an object. Now, we can create a texture coordinate node. And from this one, let's create a texture sample. And under the details panel, select the texture that we have imported. If you want to see what this node does, right-click on this and select the Start Previewing option. Go back to the texture coordinate node, change the U tiling to 12, V tiling to 8, and you should get the same result if you made it 12 by 8. Now, right-click and select the Stop Previewing option. Then create a Multiply node. Connect the RGB to the A. And from the B, create a Generated Band node. Again, to be able to see the effect, right-click on it and start previewing the node. After that, right-click on the width, promote it to a parameter, and make the default value 0.2. Then from the input coordinates, create a panel node and change the speed y to -0.5. Great, we have created an animation, so now we can stop previewing this node. Then, if we just create another max node and connect this one to the input A, multiply node to the input B, and finally connect the output of the max node to the opacity. This is the final result, and if you are happy with this, you can click on the save button and close this graph. Let's open the character blueprint, go to the viewport and add a sphere component. Let's scale this up. Something around this. Change the default material to the material that we have created. And I will change the collision preset to no collision. Compile and save the settings. Press play and have fun with the result. If you want to see more content like this, don't forget to like this video and hit the subscribe button. Once again, thanks for watching. I see you guys next time.